Nixon, I think, was the most gifted intellectually and politically president of the modern age. He was also crazy.
Because he had demons of paranoia.
Paranoia was so extreme. And he embodied the two strains of conservatism. Nixon is a central figure in this book because you see what I call revanchism, movement conservatism, and classical conservatism fused in Nixon. Nixon's policies were more liberal than any Democrat who's followed him. Remember when the late Edward Kennedy died, and we were all looking, I wrote a postmortem myself, and everyone was looking at his record. And Kennedy, what was Kennedy's regret? That he hadn't cut a deal with Nixon on health care.
Exactly.
That's better than anything we're seeing
now. Exactly right.
Now, so as a policy guy, he was.
Take me through Obama. You're willing to argue now that Richard Nixon was more gifted, and the rest of it, even including Barack Obama.
Well, I think we're leaving out a figure who, in intellectual ability, I mean, here we are ranking them all, does surpass Obama. I think Bill Clinton was extraordinarily gifted political figure.
Gifted in terms of, in what way? Gifted in what way?
In, he combined a skill at retail politics with a conceptual grasp of policy I don't think we've seen. Remember, do you ever meet Richard Newsday, the presidential historian?
Of course.
All right. I asked him once about 10 years ago, right before the impeachment, I met him, the one time I met him. And I said, how good is this guy? Is this guy as good as Roosevelt? Because remember, Roosevelt was the model for Newsday. Yeah. He said, better, more sheer talent. He said, character flaws, but better. So when I say Nixon is more gifted than Obama, he's lacking an essential component Obama has.
Emotional intelligence.
Yeah.
Emotional
intelligence and a sense of self-identity. Nixon never really fitted in anywhere. The interesting thing about Obama is that he seems to have a sort of rootless upbringing, and yet he's situated really at the center of American identity, a tremendous patriotism. We kind of forget, you know, the acceptance speech in Denver and then the inauguration address and then with the victory speech. A tremendous patriotism, sense of American history, of hope. Nixon never really felt that. The resentments and angers coursed very darkly through him.
He never adopted the politics of optimism.
No, he didn't, or the true temperament of it, which makes him fascinating. Here is a man who's a total introvert, chooses the most extroverted of professions.